Hello friends, welcome back to our video lecture series on course titled Fluid Mechanics 2. We will continue with our previous topic, centrifugal pumps, and in this lecture we will be discussing different heads of centrifugal pump. So starting from the first static head, just before proceeding what we have discussed in the previous lectures, first we have discussed working of the centrifugal pump, then we have discussed priming operation of the centrifugal pump, how it is generally done and why it is required. Then we have discussed after that. We have discussed various assumptions and basic concepts which are used in case of centrifugal pump, and then in the last lecture we have discussed work done per second by the centrifugal pump. So what was our equation for the work done per second by the impeller on the water, which was given by rho q multiplied by vw2 multiplied by u2, which can also be written as in the form of w, where w is the rho qg divided by g multiplied by VW2 multiplied by U2, where this W is given by the equation rho QG. So this is what we have discussed in the last lecture. In this lecture we will be discussing different heads which are generally considered in the centrifugal pump. The first one is the static head. Static head is the sum of the suction head and delivery head, which is known as the static head, which is given by HS is equal to small hs plus small hd, where small hs is the suction head and small hd is the delivery head. So if I am considering this is the water level from where we need to take water from this particular water level to this overhead tank, so if I measure my head from this free surface of liquid to the line which is drawn from the eye of the impeller, then this is known as suction head, because in this particular portion there will be a development of suction head, negative head, by which our water will be taken from this water source to the eye of the impeller. And if I measure the next head starting from the eye of the impeller to the that point where we want to deliver our liquid, that will become our delivery head, that would be HD. And if I add those two together, it will become static head. The next one is the manometric head. It is the head against which my centrifugal pump has to work. That is called as manometric head. Now it is generally measured across the pump inlet and pump outlet. So it is that head which we need to develop to deliver water from the source of water to the overhead tank or to the desired location. So whatever the difference between those two heads, that would be our manometric head against which my pump has to work. Of course, whenever we are delivering water from this point to this point, there will be some losses which are going to take place. So how much amount of head should be available or should be developed by the pump, that will be given by the expression in the form of a manometric head, that is given by HM is equal to head imparted by the impeller to the liquid minus loss of head in the pump, that is impeller and the casing. So if I am considering total head, or whatever the head which is generated by my impeller, which is given by the expression VW2 multiplied by U2 divided by G, if I deduct the losses, what I would get here, that is manometric head. Or even you can go for the addition of all the heads which are going to develop in the centrifugal pump, let's say starting from this whatever the suction head plus delivery head, additionally adding the losses, whatever the losses which are going to take place in the suction head, I would say that HFS. And again, what are the losses which are going to take place in the HFD, that is in the delivery pipe. And again, what are the excess head which is available at the outlet, that would be V2 square upon 2G in the delivery pipe. So if I add all those heads together, that would be a head against which my pump has to work, but that head should be get developed inside the pump, or that is getting developed in the pump. And that is called as manometric head. Now if we are not considering those losses, then in that case my expression can be written as, if losses are ignored, then a manometric head would be equal to the impeller power equation, that is VW2 U2 divided by G. So this is what the impeller power per head which is getting developed at the impeller. So this is what our manometric head, if we are ignoring those losses which are going to take place in the impeller, in the pipes or in the casing. Now that manometric head can also be written in the form of total energy equation. So if we apply Bernoulli's equation at the free surface of liquid and at the outlet, in that case what we can write down, PO upon rho g plus VO square upon 2g plus ZO, this is the total energy at the outlet point. Similarly at the inlet point, PI upon rho g plus VI square upon 2g plus ZI, that is the total energy at the inlet, that is total energy at the inlet, and this is the total energy at the outlet. Now whatever we are getting here, So at the outlet, this will be my delivery pipe. So in that case, I can write down this PO upon rho g as PD upon rho g, that is pressure in delivery pipe. Vd square upon 2g is the velocity in the delivery pipe, velocity head in the delivery pipe. Zd is the elevation of delivery pipe from the reference datum line. And again, suction head, Ps upon rho g, that is in case of suction pipe. This is the inlet head, inlet total energy, plus velocity head in the suction pipe and elevation of the suction pipe from the from the datum. Now, if our delivery and suction pipe both are of same diameter, in that case, this Vd square upon 2g and Vs square upon 2g both would become equal due to the same diameter and will get cancelled with each other. And again, if both are located at the same elevation, let us, if our centrifugal pump is having horizontal arrangement, here there will be a pump, this is a suction pipe and this is the delivery pipe. In that case, of course, our equation for the manometric head would be reduced to the Pd upon rho g minus Ps upon rho g. So this would become my manometric head. Now if you see here, it is pressure head in the delivery pipe and this is the pressure head in the suction pipe. So our suction head would be measured with by using vacuum gauge. So of course, as it is a suction head, it would be a negative. So this negative would become plus in our equation, and whatever our manometric head would be given by the pressure head in the delivery pipe plus suction head in the delivery pipe. Another expression for the computation of this manometric head, what I told you, that by adding all heads together, which is also called as manometric head, which is given by HS, head in the suction pipe plus delivery head, head in the delivery pipe plus frictional losses which are taking place in the suction pipe plus frictional losses which are taking place in the delivery pipe plus Vd square upon 2g. What are the Vd square upon 2g? Is the excess head which is available in the delivery pipe. So those are the three expressions which you can use while computing the manometric head. Remember that this manometric head is very important because it is used while computing your efficiency, or it is the head against which your pump is working. So whenever it is given that my pump is working against the head of 15 meter, that means that it is the value of manometric head of that particular pump. So that's all from this lecture. Those are the references which I used while preparing my presentation. Thank you for watching.